Hi, I'm Tapos Nayak, and I'm a fourth year PhD student at National University of Singapore, and I'll be presenting my work on effective modeling of N-Quadratic-Order architecture for joint entity and relation extraction. This is a joint work with my supervisor, Vita Wang, and this work is published in IIIA 2020. So let me first describe the task. So a relation tuple consists of two entities and a relation between them. And the task of relation extraction is about automatically extracting the relation tuples from text. We actually consider only a fixed set of relations. Like in this example, the American people can see what is happening here, said Senator Neil Ben Nelson, Democrat of Nebraska. And it contains tuples like Ben Nelson lives in Nebraska, Ben Nelson political party Democrat, and Ben Nelson professor senator. The challenge in this task is lack of manually annotated text tuple parallel data. So Minch et al., Rydell et al., Hoffman et al., they proposed an idea of distance supervision where existing tuples from the knowledge bases are mapped to the text. The idea is that if a sentence contains both the entities of a tuple, then the sentence is considered the source of the tuple. They consider this tuple, Barack Obama was born in Hawaii. Now a sentence, if Barack Obama was born in 1961 in Hawaii. So since this sentence contains two entities, Barack Obama and Hawaii, so it will be considered as a source of this tuple. One approach to solve this problem is a pipeline approach. So it has two steps. First, find the entities in the sentence. So here in this sentence, American, Senator, Ben Nelson, Nebraska, Democrat, these are the entities. And among all the pairs of entities, or find the relations, like between Ben Nelson, Nebraska lives in relation. Now sometimes between two entities, there may not be any relation, like Nebraska Democrat, there is no relation. So the problem with these approaches, there will be a lot of no relation tuples. Another approach is joint approach, where the entities or relations are extracted together. It only extracts the valid tuples, so no relation tuples problem will be solved. And it can capture the interaction of the multiple tuples. The challenges in joint approach is that we have to extract all the tuples, even if it's multiple more than one. Overlapping tuples, like tuples may be shared across the, entities may be shared across the tuples, like one entity or two entity. Then entities do not have uniform length, so we have to extract all of them, like single token or double, two token or multi token. Then we have to extract new entities from the test data also. So these are the contributions. So we propose two novel approaches to use the N-Quadratic-Order framework for joint extraction task. Our goal is to address all the challenges as described above. We propose a word-level decoding framework which extracts one word at each time step and can still find the multiple tuples with overlapping entities and multi-token entities. And we propose a mask-based copy mechanism to extract the entities from the source sentence. We also propose a pointer network-based decoding framework to make the N-Quadratic-Order model more suitable for this task. So this pointer network framework can extract an entire tuple in a single step. It actually improves the training time and consume less resources. And both our approaches achieve state of the performance on the New York Times dataset. So this is a general architecture for a N-Quadratic-Order model. So this kind of model is generally used for machine translation. Like we have an English word sentence and then we have Indonesian sentences and translate from English to Indonesian. So it has an encoder part and a decoder part, and encoder decoder actually communicate with each other with an attention layer. So at the encoder, there will be a source embedding which will contains all the source tokens of that source sentence, and at the decoder there is a target embedding which will contain all the tokens from that target sentences. The encoder has generally a bidirectional stream which takes the input as the pre-trained word embedding and then generate the hidden vectors. The decoder generally contains a LSTM. It takes the attention vector from the source context, which is the ET, and the hidden vector of the LSTM from the previous time step and the previous target token, and then generate a new hidden state. And this new hidden vector is mapped to the target embedding using a linear layer and a softmax layer. So the target side, we will have a start of sequence token and an end of sequence token. Now, in our encoder decoder architecture, we use a pretty simple encoder. Like we represent the words with the pretend word embedding and the character level feature. We use CNN with max pooling to extract the character level feature. We concatenate them with the word pretend word embedding and pass it to a bidirectional STM to encode them. Now, the major problem with the general encoder decoder of the encoder decoder framework is that the entities can be of different lengths. So because of that, there is no uniformity among the tuples. So we don't know when the decoder is generating an entity or when the decoder is generating it, generating a new tuple. So that's why we cannot use them directly. So for that, we propose two representation schemes. Like first, we propose a special separator-based representation and the corresponding decoding algorithm. And then the pointer network-based representation and the corresponding decoding framework. So first, we have a separator-based tuple representation. So this is the sentence, and it contains two tuple here. So now this is the way we represent the tuple. So first we have a start of sequence token, then we have the entity one, then we have a separator, then entity two, then a separator, then the relation name, then another separator to separate the tuple, then the first entity of the second tuple, then the separator, then another entity, then the separator, then another entity, then relation, and then the end of sequence token. So if we represent the tokens tuples in this way, then the encoder decoder architecture can extract the tuples. So for that, we have to change something in the model. So first, we have to use the joint embedding. So since our entities mostly comes from the source sentence itself, so we don't need to separate embedding at the encoder decoder. We can combine them into a single embedding. And since the relation names also will be generated in the same way the entities are generated, so we add the relation names also in the embedding. And also we add the separator tokens to the embedding. And also we use a mask-based copy mechanism. And if we look at the projection of the decoder, it maps the decoder LSTM hidden vector to entire vocabulary. So it is possible that the model is extracting an entity which is not in the source sentence itself. So that is why what we do is before applying the soft mask operation, we mask or exclude all the words from the vocabulary except the source sentence tokens, relation tokens, unknown tokens, EOS tokens, and the special separator tokens. And how do you do the inference? So during inference, after decoding is finished, we extract all the tuples based on the separators. We remove the duplicate tuples and tuples in which both entities are same, or the tuples where the relation names are not from the relation set. And if the decoder generates UNK token, we replace it with the corresponding source word, which has the highest attention score. So this will help the model to identify new entities during the inference. We use three different attention. One is the average, another is n-gram-based attention, another is a single attention. This attention is the standard Bahadur's attention in the machine translation. So this attention actually perform better than the other. There are some issues with the word level decoding, which are like decoder may fail to generate the separator tokens at the proper time step. So in that case, we cannot extract the entities and replace them. Then it may fail to generate the relation names at the proper time step. And it may repeat the same entity in a tuple. And decoder cannot generate the entity tokens which are not in the vocabulary. So it is difficult to extract the new entities during the inference. So we propose another representation, which is the pointer network based. So here, this is the same sentence, but here these numbers are the index of these tokens. So now we have two tuples, same tuples. Now the tuples are represented using a five things. Like this is the start index of the first entity, the end index of the first entity, this is the start index of the second entity, this is the start end index of the second entity, and this is the relation. And then we represent all the tuples in a uniform way. And we use a dummy tuple at the beginning with SOS relation and dummy tuple at the end with US relation. So we don't need any word vocabulary at the decoder side. Only we need it at the encoder side. We use the separate embedding at the relation names at the decoder side. And the special tokens are also not used anymore. So this is our network. So this is the on the left side, we have the general encoder decoder architecture. Now this is the decoding block. This decoding block usually generally have only single LSTM cell, but we replaced it with this pointer network with decoding framework. So this decoding framework has major four component. First is the LSTM, which is the sequence generator. So this LSTM generates the sequence of tuples. And then we have a bi-LSTM with two feed forward layer. This feed forward layer actually gives us the probability distribution of a token being the start index of the entity one. This feed forward network gives the normalized probabilities of the tokens being the end of the entity one. Similarly, this gives the probabilities for the entity two. Now, these probabilities are actually basically you can consider them as an attention score. So, using this attention score, if you do an weighted average and then concatenate, you can get a entity representation here for entity one and entity two. Now, we concatenate this representation with the fit forward layer here and classify the relation. After relation classification, we use the relation embedding layer here to get the relation embedding and then concatenate with the entity to entity representation to get the entire tuple representation. This entire tuple representation is added to all previously generated tuples and pass it to the LSTM to generate the next tuple. So this is how it will go on. And when it generates the EOS relation, then the decoding process stops. So this is the equation for the sequence generator LSTM. This is the equations for the pointer generators. I'm not going into details. And this is the equation for the getting the entity representation vector and the relation classification equation. So during inference, we select the start and end location of the two entities such that the product of the pointer probabilities are four pointer probabilities are maximized. We use two constraints. One is that end index will be always later than the beginning index, and two entities will not overlap with each other. Here in the at pointer network also, we use the Bahadur's attention with three variations. The variations are applied in these equations mainly. So first we use the hidden vector of the LSTM to get the Q. Then we use the Y prev to get the Q, and then use the combination of hidden vector and the Y prev to get the Q. So there are some advantages of the pointer network-based decoding. It is the training is much faster and consume less GPU memory. It always accepts two entities and one relation for a tuple. And generation of the same entity in a tuple can be avoided easily using our constraint during inference. And since it is pointing in the source sentence itself for the entity location, so it will be easier for it to identify the new entities during inference. We use these two loss functions. For the word level decoding, we use the categorical quotient for every token. And for pointer network based decoding, we use categorical quotient for the all the relation and the beginning and end index of the two entities. We use the NYT29 and NYT24 datasets of Takanobu et al. And Zeng et al. For our experiments. This data set has 29 relation and this data has 24 relation. We use PS and recall and F1 score, and a tuple is considered as correct if both entities are relation match. We use the what2vec pretend embedding of dimension 300 and use Adam optimizer to optimize the network. We use dropout for the to prevent the overfitting. We report actually median of the five runs. And then we combine the five runs using a majority voting to get the ensemble model. So these are the main results. So this is the column for the single model and this is the column for the ensemble model. And we can see that our what quad level decoding and quantum network based decoding actually outperform the previous baselines. And in the ensemble also we compare with the HRL model, and our model actually, our ensemble parsing actually outperform this model by significant 4% margin. These are some applications. For word level decoding, we use the three type of attention, and then on top of that, we apply the copy mechanism. And we see that at the bar on a single attention with copy mechanism achieve the best performance. And if we compare with the every attention with the corresponding copy mechanism, we can see that copy mechanism actually improves the performance by 5 to 7% for every attention type. And for the pointer network based, we can see that combination of two decoder, the combo version of the attention actually achieve the state of the performance, although the difference may not be very significant here. Now, if we look at the performance in the two data set, we can see that there is a significant gap between the N2029 and N2024. So the difference is almost around 12%. So we analyze what is the reason. The reason is that NYT24 dataset has 72% upper overlap between training and test data, whereas NYT29 has only 42%. So basically during training, the model already seen 72% of tuples in the training. So that's why it performs better on the NYT24. And also I already told that a pointer network-based model is much faster and consume less resources. And the reason is that word level decoding has a very costly softmax operation. So the projection layer where the decoder LSTM hidden vector is mapped to the entire vocabulary of the decoder, the vocabulary size can be very large, like 40,000 words. And so backpropagation have to update all the embeddings for the entire vocabulary. So that is a very costly operation. But for pointer network based decoding, we only apply the softmax only the across the sentence length, which is around maybe 50 to 100, and across the regression set, which is around 25 to 30, so which is not much. Also, to generate on entire tuple, word level decoding has to go through multiple times. It has to generate all the tokens, separated tokens, everything. But in case of pointer network, in a single step, it can give you the four pointer probabilities, distribution, and the regression. That's why the pointer network models are much faster and consume less resources. In summary, we propose two novel approaches to use the encoder decoder network for joint extraction of entities and relation. Our model actually achieves state of the performance on NRT dataset. Our code and data is available in the GitHub, so if you have any question, you can post your question there. And thanks for listening.